Katie Kafer, and I'm a first year, fourth grade teacher in the Chicago suburbs. This is my first ever video, so I thought I would do the teacher tag to help you get to know me a little bit better. So here we go. All right, starting off here, well, I kind of already answered this first question, but it says, what do you teach and where? So it's my first year teaching, as I mentioned before, and this year I am teaching in a fourth grade classroom in the Chicago suburbs. Number two, I have everything on my computer here. How long have you been teaching? So again, it's my first year teaching. The first day of school is on September 1st. I got the job mid-August, so I had been prepping for like putting together my classroom and everything like that since mid-August, but the first day of school was September 1st. And the school year before that, I was an instructional aide in a first grade classroom, which was so much fun. And then the year before that, in 2018, in the fall, I student taught for that 18-week semester period. Ooh, number three, did you always know you wanted to teach? I wouldn't actually say so, no. I originally went into college declared as a graphic design major. I had taken, you know, all those Photoshop classes, photography classes, art classes in high school, and I loved them. So I was just kind of like, eh? Like, I kind of like that kind of stuff. So I kind of just went for it. But one day, I vividly remember this night because it was obviously so pivotal. It kind of changed my career path and the way that my life just went after that. But I was actually at my then boyfriend's house. Now he's my husband. I was at his house one night and we were just talking. It was a few, I don't remember exactly the time actually, but it was like right before I started college and we were just talking about that and talking about if I was nervous or excited, all that good stuff. And I remember just kind of having a heart-to-heart with him in that moment, and I was talking to him about graphic design and what I was excited about, and I vividly remember just kind of looking at him and being like, oh my gosh, I don't really know how I feel anymore about being a graphic, like, declaring a graphic design major, and I kind of freaked out then. If you know me, I can really go into spirals of thought and I can really overthink a lot of things. And I think this was one of those moments because graphic design, I think looking back, it could have worked really well for me because I consider myself to be a creative person and I love doing that kind of like artsy stuff. But in that particular moment, I remember just feeling like, oh, I feel like the graphic designers I know either join a firm or join something and do graphic design for a company, or they create their own business. And both of those options just didn't seem like they fit well with me. They didn't jive with me for some reason in that moment. And my boyfriend, and being the great person that he was, he just listened and asked me questions and helped me kind of like process through this big moment with me. And we ended up coming to the conclusion, or I ended up coming to the conclusion that I didn't want to be a graphic design major and I wanted to go into education. And he loved that idea. He said that he could definitely see me being in education, and more specifically in elementary education, because of how much I love kids. And another sweet thing that happened that night is after I came back to my house, I told my mom, because she was like all through when I was in school, she was an elementary school teacher too. And so I told her what happened at my boyfriend's house, and she was thrilled. And the sweetest thing happened is we were just sitting at the kitchen island in my kitchen, and I told her, and I remember her going, oh, like, well, Katie, I was kind of hoping you would maybe change your mind and become elementary education, because I have been saving all of my teaching things for you in our basement. And I remember being like, oh my gosh. And we went into my basement and she showed me this room that was full of just like knickknacks, books, board books, like children's books, everything, just wonderful teaching things. And it almost makes me want to cry now, but Wow, so sweet. And obviously looking back now, I am just thriving. I love teaching and it's definitely where I'm supposed to be and the decision I was supposed to make. But yeah, originally to answer the question, no. I didn't always know that I wanted to be an elementary school teacher, but I am so glad I made that decision. All right, what is your typical teacher OOTD, your outfit of the day? So it honestly depends on how I'm feeling that day or the day before. I like to, when I'm feeling responsible and motivated, I like to pick out my outfits the night before so I don't have to worry about choosing an outfit in a rush the morning of getting ready for school. Sorry, if you can hear my puppy, he's like gnawing on a hanger in the background, so sorry about that. So yeah, it just mostly depends on how I'm feeling, but I will say that I worked at Old Navy in high school, and then I came back when I went to college, like during breaks and stuff, and I worked at Old Navy still. So from that discount that I got working there, I had accumulated so many Old Navy clothes. So I have a bunch of, you know, cardigans. I personally like their like skinny, I think they're called the rock star jeans. I have a few of those. I've grown to like just the basic tees. So that's what I would typically say I would wear. This year, my room has so many windows, which is lovely. So that really drastically changes the temperature on any given day. So usually, no matter what the weather is, I've done this since the beginning of school and the beginning of September. I've liked to just prepare for the temperature of my classroom by just wearing layers. I remember I like to wear dresses. I really love dresses because it's just one piece of clothing, one piece of cloth, just slip it on over. So I really like wearing those, and then if it was randomly cool, I always had like a cardigan to just throw on. And then it's the same now as it's getting really cold in Illinois and really dreary. I like to just have a cardigan, bring it into school at the beginning of the week, and then I like to honestly just kind of keep it there. And then just to kind of throw it on, take it off, because I move around a lot when I teach, so sometimes that makes me kind of hot. So I like to just kind of have layers ready to go, so I'm ready for whatever temperature I feel throughout the day. What do you usually bring for lunch? So I usually, every day, I mean, it kind of changes depending on what my husband and I get when we go grocery shopping, but I always, as a staple, I have really liked, or my husband and I have really liked, we call it the snack packs from Aldi, where it's those little packs of, you know, on one side it's some cheese, and on the other side, our favorite is cheese on one side, and then dried cranberries and almonds on the other side. Those are always, one of those is always in my lunchbox every single day. I just love them because they're just quick and easy to just throw in and not really have to worry about. And then depending on if my husband and I meal prepped for the week beforehand, sometimes I have some sort of pasta, or sometimes I like to just have those ready-made salads where I just dump the contents all over it and dump some salad dressing on it. Usually have something like that, and then sometimes if I have time or if I feel like it, I throw in like a cinnamon applesauce in there. That's usually what I pack for my lunch. Oh, I don't know if this counts, but what is your favorite teacher movie? That's how it was worded in the question, and I know this isn't like a teacher movie where like the main character is a teacher, but the first thing I thought of was, or the first character I thought of was Miss Honey from Matilda. And I know, again, that's not like a teacher movie, but Miss Honey came straight to mind because I really strive to have the patience and the grace that she has towards her students. I love this question. Who was your favorite teacher? This is gonna take a while. I have a lot because I'm so blessed to be able to say that I have so many favorite teachers all the way through like elementary school, all the way through high school. So many great teachers, and honestly, all of them are great. I'll name a couple like through each school that I went to. If that makes sense. My kindergarten teacher was one of my favorites, and then my fifth grade teacher was one of my favorites. It's neat that they kind of were on either end of my elementary journey. Oh my gosh, but Mrs. DeBoard in kindergarten. I don't even know if I can put her into words, honestly. The sweetest woman you will ever meet. I don't know, like, what other words to use for Mrs. DeBoard. She sang to us. She had us sing a lot of songs. A lot of them I still remember. Oh my gosh. She just, like, this might sound weird to say, but hopefully you'll understand, is that she just had the most soothing, kind voice. Such a sweet woman. What a gem. And then my fifth grade teacher, Mrs. Hospelhorn, so sweet, similar to Mrs. DeBoard. But wow, she was so passionate about teaching. Wow, Mrs. Hospelhorn, she made fifth grade so much fun. I remember before every test, she gave us those just like peppermint, like little peppermints before class, because she said that it would help us focus, which in fifth grade, we thought that was the coolest thing, and it still kind of is the coolest thing. And then also before tests, she blasted the cha-cha slide and had us all stand up and do the cha-cha slide all the way through to get our nerves out before all of our tests. And I remember her just being so energetic, and she just made learning so much fun. But yeah, that was my favorite elementary school teachers. And for middle school, again, all of mine are great in middle school. I had so many because I went 6th through 8th grade at my middle school. And one teacher of mine from middle school that just sticks out the most right away is Mr. Harris. He was my 7th grade math teacher. And again, similarly to Mrs. Hospelhorn, he just made learning math so much fun. Because personally, going through school, math was just a little bit harder for me to understand, and I had, I just needed some more help with it, and he explained the concepts in just such new and interesting ways that made so much sense to me. And even more than that, he was just so funny, and he just made everyone laugh and smile, which I just think is so important and so special. So I love Mr. Harris in middle school. And oh my gosh, high school, wow. High school just in general was just fabulous. So many wonderful teachers that I had, but one comes to mind again, just like middle school, and that was Mr. Feeney in my senior year AP English class. Wow. I guess to make a long story short, because I could talk for hours about him, honestly, he made me and he kind of helped me shape my teaching philosophy now, if that makes sense. In high school, I didn't know that I would be a teacher, but when I was crafting my education philosophy in college, I thought about Mr. Feeney a lot, honestly, because he not only just taught the concepts really well of English, which is really important, but in my opinion, more importantly, he just made every single student in our class feel seen, known, and loved. And he did that in such a different way for everybody, which is just fantastic and honestly makes me want to tear up, because he just got to know every student in my class that year in such a genuine way, and you could tell how much he cared for each of us, and we honestly just felt like a family. And that's all that I strive for my classrooms to feel like too. So I honestly look up to Mr. Feeney a lot with education and just how I want to make my students feel too. Ooh, this one's fun. Who are some of your favorite teacher YouTubers, Instagrammers, Snapchatters, etc.? So I'm not much of a Snapchatter. I've tried it. I don't know. I would just be on my phone way too much if I had all of the social media things. So I am mainly on, and I follow more teachers on Instagram and now YouTube. I have been following and loving here on YouTube Elementary with Emma. I love her for many reasons, but we're similarly aged. We're both in our first year of teaching during a pandemic, so she's just super relatable and really like easy to listen to, and I like the content she puts out. I also really like, I made a list. I follow quite a few. I really like Elementary and the Mitten here on YouTube too. Her energy is infectious and her love for reading inspires me. Her classroom library is beautiful, among many other things of why I follow her. I really like watching her videos because she has great ideas that inspire me to be my best for my students too. And then another person that I love, one of the first teacher YouTubers that I started watching when I got my job this year was, actually even before I got my job, I started following and loving Primarily Yours here on YouTube. Primarily Yours, just like everybody else, she's a similar age to me, so she's super relatable. I love her energy as well. You can tell how much she cares, and you can tell how genuine she is on the camera, which I really appreciate. And I can tell how much she has a passion for teaching. All these women have inspired me to kind of take a leap of faith and start this channel as well. And Instagram, I kind of said it already, but I follow all those accounts on Instagram as well. Elementary and the Mitten, Elementary with Emma, Primarily Yours. I follow a bunch of teacher Instagrammers, honestly. I love Maniacs in the Middle. I love her content. There he is, star of the show. I love following Sanders in Second. Those are the main ones that I love to follow, but there's so many others. I love the Instagram, the Teachergram world. This next one, what is one of your best classroom management tips? I was even hesitant to include this answer question in here because, as I mentioned, I've been teaching since September with my own set of kiddos. So I just don't want to come off as feeling like a know-it-all, because I certainly am not. I'm kind of learning as I go. I feel like that's just a part of how it is with your first few years of teaching. I would say, thinking back, my class is wonderful. So I think that's a huge part of why I feel like my management, like, systems, I guess, have gone so well this year, is because my students have been super receptive. And they're fourth grade, so they've been in school for a while, so they know how to school, which really helps. But I also think that the certain things that I've done and certain things that I've put into place have really helped things go smoothly as well. I can definitely make a video about this if you're interested. But something that I do every day, I've done it since the first day of school, is make a Google Slides for the whole day. So I start off, like, I make like a message to put up on my smart board screen, and I just give 1, 2, 3, just a list of directions, like put your backpack away, find your seat. Off the top of my head, we've been going, like, we're working on our multiplication facts, so I have them go on a website where they just quick do almost like multiplication flashcards until the bell rings, like some sort of bell ringer activity. And so I have slides like that through each subject of the day all day. So I like to write or type out the objectives for each, like, lesson that's about to happen, so my kids know what's expected of them and what they're going to learn about for each subject. And that just honestly helps the day go so smoothly. Not only just for my students, so they know what's expected of them at all times, but it's also really helpful for me to keep myself on track. Or sometimes, if you know me, I can be pretty, like, scatterbrained and I'm kind of forgetful. So the slides, honestly, like, if I click on the next slide and I forget that we're doing something, the slides are like, oh yeah, it's time for a bathroom break. That kind of thing. So it honestly helps keep me on track. And then for the couple times that I've had to get just like a sub that I didn't plan for, that's happened a couple times this year so far, the slides have helped the sub just coming on in, not really like, it just helps everybody. Slides like that help everybody. And as I said before, I'm definitely open to showing how I create those slides and going, like, diving deeper into how I make them and why I make them and why I use them and stuff and how they're so helpful. But that's really helped my management in general every single day since September. And another thing, I feel like this is said a lot, but my management system, like, I feel like it's worked so well this year because of the relationships that I've built with my students since the very first day of school. I just make it clearly known on the first day of school what I expect of my kids, that I just expect respect from them, that's hard to say. And then in return, like, you know, you show me respect, I show you respect. That's how it works. It goes both ways. I kind of say that and I make that very well known, very clear since the first day of school. And then I build relationships with each of my students from there. Thinking back to my AP English teacher in high school, I really think about him a lot when it comes to relationships, and I try to get to know each of my students just the way that Mr. Feeney got to know everyone in my English class my senior year of high school. And then I think everything, not everything falls into place, but a lot of things, honestly, in my opinion, fall into place when those genuine relationships are built with students. Because I believe if your students want to respect you, it'll happen. Like, make it so that your kids want to respect you and listen to you. And then I think you obviously have to do some work after that, but relationships, man, they're just the key, I feel like. This is the last one. Oh, what is one reason you decided to become a teacher? So, if my freshman year education, like my first education class, if that professor of that class is watching this right now, I don't know, she'd be happy with my answer. But it's just because I love kids. The first words out of my professor's mouth for my first education class was, you know, we had to go around and introduce ourselves and we had to say why we wanted to be a teacher. But before we even started that activity, I remember she said, and I understand where she's coming from, but the first thing she said was, if you want to be a teacher because you love kids, have them, but don't teach them. And so everyone I remember was kind of like, oh my gosh. Now, looking back, I understand the intentionality behind saying that. Like, I understand where she was coming from, but I don't know if I'm fully with her on that statement, because it doesn't make much sense to me if you hate kids and you're in education. Doesn't match up in my brain. I don't know if it does for anybody else, but I love kids, and something comes over me when I interact with them. I don't know what happens. I said this in my interview for the position I have now. My puppy. Ouch. Just absolutely 100% know that this is my calling and this is what I'm supposed to be doing with my life, because I absolutely thrive in like an environment with kids, watching them grow, watching them learn, watching those light bulb moments happen, and then knowing that you're the one that made that happen is just the very best. I can't explain it, but the fast answer is just that I love kids and I just absolutely love, love, love interacting with them and being with them every single day.
All right.
Well, there. Just burped. Well, there you go. We're done. 10 questions. I hope you liked this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you would like to see more videos like this one. Bye.